Welcome back to DWD TV. I'm Summer.
And I'm Jacob. We have everything on the show, from captivating interviews to Daniel's winning golf team.
So Jacob, what do you do besides school?
Well, I work as a waiter, I play in my church choir, and I'm part of the yearbook club.
That's a lot of stuff.
Yeah, Daniel students tend to do a lot.
Here's Maddie with an interview with another one of our busy Daniel students.
Hey Dido, we just interviewed Peyton Bagby to see what her life outside of school is like. Let's go see what she has to say.
I started dancing when I was 3 years old, and I really just started because my mom signed me up. I was never in soccer or volleyball, I was just always dance. The biggest challenge with dance is that perfection really is never achieved. There's always something you're working at or trying to improve on or trying to accomplish. It's never finished. I think dance allows me to escape everything going on in my life just because I can put every emotion, every feeling I have into a dance and make it something really, really special for other people. I think it's important for me to make this special for other people because I'm the big girl at dance, and so I'm constantly being watched by the little girls, and I want them to have someone positive to look up to, and I want them to see something more than just a routine. I want them to see a story.
Dance and schoolwork.
I don't sleep. I'm Maddie with DWTV.
Thanks, Maddie, for sharing Peyton's talent with us.
You think you know someone because you see them every day at school, but then you get a snapshot of their lives outside of school and you're always blown away.
Me too. But if I'm being honest, I'm only starting to learn about all these things we have at school. I've been hearing some new things about the new theater troupe.
That's right, Jacob. Mr. Whitley is directing a competitive theater troupe, and Thomas wants to help us find a little bit more.
All right, here's Thomas with Mr. Whitley and some of the club members.
Thanks, guys. So, our new English teacher, Mr. Whitley, has started a competitive theater troupe. Here's a sneak peek at the 1969 rendition of Antigone.
A student taught at Daniel a couple years ago, always wanted to get back. Loved the theater program here. And just wanted to bring this new aspect to it. I've got a lot of friends that are theater teachers that do this sort of thing. Seems like a lot of fun. I thought Antigone would be cool just because Daniel, I know, does a lot of comedies, which is awesome. I love comedies, but to bring something a little bit more dramatic. Plus, I know some classes that Daniel read Antigone, so something we're a little bit familiar with. And then as far as the 60s go, of course, Antigone's set thousands of years ago. So bring it up, make it something that's a little bit more relatable. And Antigone's all about protest, so it seems to fit perfectly in the late 60s.
Thanks, Thomas. That was really cool.
Is it to be or not to be?
That's pretty good. Maybe you should audition for the next competition.
Thanks. But those guys are so good. I don't think I would measure up against them.
I'm looking forward to seeing their competition performance. But right now, I'm looking forward to lunch. And fall. But mostly lunch. So, Jacob, what's your favorite seasonal themed food?
I love pecan pie in the fall and Mexican hot chocolate when it's cold. We only make them when it's cold out, and it's so good. How about you? What's your favorite seasonal item?
I like pumpkin pie with whipped cream.
Pumpkin pie is definitely a seasonal item. Here's Hannah to show us how Daniel students feel about their seasonal foods.
We asked some of our fellow Daniel students to try some pumpkin spice flavored foods. Let's go see if they can spice it.
So the first thing you'll be trying today is a pumpkin spice Pop-Tart.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. I actually don't like that. Do you like it?
It's kind of good.
Do you like pumpkin spice?
That's disgusting. It's super mainstream and just not about it at all whatsoever. That's just not me.
Alright, so I think next up is some pumpkin spice granola.
I got a raisin.
It's not bad.
What's your favorite fall food?
Caramel apples.
So the next thing you'll be trying is a pumpkin roll.
Really good. Yep. I'm gonna eat it all.
No! I feel like pumpkin spice and I are the same person. I like love pumpkin spice so much.
So the last thing is a pumpkin smoothie.
Gosh, dang.
Bottoms up.
I got more than you.
You did.
You drank a lot of it. Oh, we're still going.
I'm gonna regret that later.
There's not a single thing that I love more than pumpkin spice.
Wow, I didn't know there were so many things that you can actually pumpkin spice.
Thanks, Hannah. Do you think there's any of that pumpkin roll left?
I doubt it. The only thing rolling around here is the end of the first 9 weeks. Ugh, this is the last quarter that will show up on my transcript. I'm freaking out.
I know, me too. But I don't think we have a resource to help us when school gets hard.
Thank you. How could I have gotten a zero?
Go to the tutoring after school, Tuesdays and Thursdays.
I'm going to sign up right now. I have got to make sure that the end of this quarter looks good.
Your grades aren't the only thing wrapping up. The swim team finished their season with the girls coming 8th in the state. And band is ready for the upper state qualifiers, especially after their grand championship in Pendleton. And as we saw last week, volleyball and cross country are continuing on strong.
For sure. Don't forget that girls golf won the upper state championship this weekend. And state is right around the corner. Let's see what Aiden has on deck in sports this morning.
Hey Daniel, this week we did a feature on girls golf and highlights on football and tennis. Enjoy.
When you're playing golf, like everything you do is on you. Like you hit it out of bounds, you miss that putt.
Like, well, it's more of like you just gotta get over the bad shots and
yeah.
Just worry about getting the next one closer.
Something that can happen to you on two and you still have 16 more holes to play, so you just gotta get over it and move on. Yeah. And if you know your teammates are playing good, then that's even more motivation to play good because you wanna benefit them, like you want their score to mean something if you're playing good too, because then all together it's even better. So
this is my favorite year, I have to say. It's
for
just
sure
been so much fun just being all together, and we've grown up all 4 years. I know Jillian came here for her freshman year, but just being here all 4 years has been great.
What's it like to play with your two sisters?
It's fun. Like we are get very competitive. Like in the first tournament of the season, my sister that's in seventh grade beat me. She shot 79 and she beat me. So I heard about that for a couple weeks. And then I feel like it's just good because when we're practicing and stuff, we just are so competitive and we like are always playing against each other. And it's also fun though, because I never have to practice by myself. Like there's always one of them there. But it's fun. I like being around them, so it's fun.
Our Daniel Lions deck the Hogs 45-14 for a Christmas-themed homecoming game, making us 7-0 this season. Jared Kirksey and David Cody are leading a tough defense this year. Jared had 3 sacks during the game, and David currently leads the state in tackles. At halftime, Morgan Davis was crowned homecoming queen, and Marissa Swedberg crowned homecoming princess. Not only did our team show out for the game, but our band, student section, and cheer did as well. The girls' tennis team is doing great. They recently had their senior night. Our Lady Lions went undefeated at regions, making them number 1 in the region. We look forward to them doing well at their playoffs. Cheer plays second on Saturday for their competition here at Daniel. Here's a clip. I'm Tyler Kellogg, and that was D-Dub Sports. Bye.
Good luck to all of our Daniel teams this week, and come watch the band on Saturday.
That wraps up this episode of DWD TV. Have a great weekend!